Hello students, we have already studied about plastic pollution. In plastic pollution, we studied that plastic has entered in every sphere of the activity of man. If we look around in a room, in our house, in our college, in our university, we will find that plastic items are available everywhere. In that module, we also studied about different type of plastics. Then we studied the harmful effects of plastic, and then we studied that how we can do the management of plastic technologically. Government of India has given certain laws, certain rules for the effective management of the plastic waste in the country. Actually, in 2016, all the waste management rules were revamped to have effective management of all kind of waste. So, in that series, plastic waste management rules were also revamped. So, the rules those were given in 2016 with respect to plastic management, they are called as plastic waste management rules. So, today in this module, we shall be discussing about salient features and different conditions which are given in the plastic waste management rules 2016. The learning objectives of this module are to learn about the plastic waste management rules in India, to take cognizance of the implementation of plastic waste management rules 2016, to understand the role played by judiciary for management of the plastic waste in India, and to gauge the role played by the executive machinery in containing the problem of plastic waste in India. You know, plastics are made from long chains of hydrocarbons that are derived from petroleum products. Application of plastic in form of packaging films, wrapping materials, then shopping garbage bags, fluid containers, clothing, toys, etc. Petro-based non-biodegradable plastics are increasingly becoming a cause of concern. Share of plastic waste in India has increased from 0.6% in 1996 to 9.2% in 2005. So, we can say the percentage of plastic in the overall solid waste is increasing. About 4,059 tons of plastic waste is generated every day in 60 major cities, and 25,940 tons is generated all over the India. This is given by CPCB in one of its surveys. The ratio of plastic to total municipality solid waste ranges between 3.1% in Chandigarh to 12.47% in Surat. 94% of plastic waste comprises of recyclable material, while 6% has non-recyclable content. Unregistered industries are involved in the manufacturing or recycling of substandard plastic, means the carry bags or the plastic that is less than 40 microns. A number of unregistered companies are involved in that. Plastic carry bags are itself a problem. Potential cost of littering plastic waste inadequately recognized in most parts of the world. Plastic bags fill up our landfills, and they are environmentally unfriendly and take hundreds of years to degrade. Plastics or carry bags, they are known to clog the drains in the plains as well as in the hilly areas. Soil and sewage, indiscriminate disposal by burning releases toxic substances and pollute the air. Means plastics or carry bags are causing harm to all components of the environment. It has also been reported that if some carry bag enter into some say forest area, wherever that plastic bag will be laying, under that no seed can grow, and that may happen for
hundreds of years. So with this background, we understand that plastics are harmful and effective management is required. For the effective management, certain legal options are there. Laws have been promulgated, laws have been enacted. Let me see them one by one. So, plastic waste management rules in India. Plastic manufacture, sales and usage rules were enacted in India in 1999 and they were amended in 2003 under Environment Protection Act 1986. In 1990 rules were made for the carry bags, and in those laws, condition was given that recycled carry bags will not be used for the packaging of foods. The rules amended in 2003 as a Recycled Plastic Manufacture and Usage Rule 2003. Important provisions made under Recycled Plastic Manufacture and Usage Rules 2003 are that stocking, distribution or sale of carry bags made of virgin or recycled plastic was prohibited. Means a blanket ban was put on the carry bags. Another condition in 2000 rules was on prohibition on use of recycled plastic bags or containers for storing, carrying, dispensing or packaging of food items. Then registration of manufacturer of plastic bags was made essential and or compulsory. Then plastic waste management and handling rules 2011 replaced recycled plastic manufacture and usage rules 2003. Means 2000 rules were replaced by the 2011 rules. And basically 2000 rules were meant to limit plastic waste in the country. Let me come to plastic waste management handling rules 2011. According to 2011 rules, the minimum thickness of plastic bags was raised to 40 microns. Earlier this was 20 micron, and recycled carry bags to conform to the norms of the Bureau of Indian Standards. A ban was put on using plastic sachet for storing, packaging or selling gutka, tobacco or pan masala. Then plastic waste management and handling rules 2011 were replaced by plastic waste management rules 2016. As I told earlier, that all waste management rules were revamped, were amended or revised in 2016, and same we did with plastic waste management rules. Plastic waste management rules 2016 replaced the rules of 2011. These plastic waste management rule 2016 were notified on 18th March 2016 in the Official Gazette by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change under sections 6, 8 and 25 of Umbrella Act, that is Environment Protection Act 1986. Let me come to the objectives of the plastic waste management rules 2016. The various objectives or aims of promulgating the plastic waste management rule 2016 include to increase minimization of plastic waste, because we understand that plastic use has increased to a large extent and we don't have any alternate that can completely replace the plastic. So in that situation, we have to minimize the plastic waste. Another objective is to enable and increase source segregation and recycling of plastic waste. Then to increase involvement of waste pickers, recyclers and waste processors in collection of plastic waste fraction, either from households or any other source of its generation or intermediate material recovery facility. Another objective is to adopt polluters pay principle for the sustainability of the waste management system. Then to ensure effective plastic management so as to minimize threats posed to the environment by the plastics. So these were the objective Keeping these objectives in view, these 2016 rules were given. Now, let me come to the application of plastic waste management rules 2016. Actually, plastic waste management and handling rule 2011 were not applicable to the Gram Panchayats. So, when those rules were not applicable to the Gram Panchayats, it means a vast area of the country was left unattended, means no rules were there for a large area of the country for plastic waste management. So, in plastic waste management rules 2016, these rules are applicable to the rural India also, means now the 2016 rules cover whole of the India. These rules apply to every waste generator, local body, Gram Panchayat, manufacturer, producer and importer. But these rules doesn't apply to the export oriented units or units in special economic zones. This exemption shall not apply to units engaged in packaging of gutkha, tobacco and pan masala, and also to any surplus or reject plastics. Let me come to the structure of plastic waste management rules 2016. These rules have one schedule, 6 forms and 17 rules. Let me come to the schedule. Basically, this schedule is in the light of rule 10, and rule 10 talk about protocols for compostable plastic materials. According to rule 10, determination of the degree of degradability and degree of disintegration of plastic material shall be as per the protocols of Indian standards listed in schedule 1 of these rules. Let we have a look on the different forms that are given in the plastic waste management rules 2016. These rules are having a total of 6 forms. Form 1 is related with the application for registration for producers or brand owners. Form 2 is an application form for registration of units engaged in processing or recycling of plastic waste. Form 3 is also the format of an application that is for registration for manufacturers of plastic raw materials. In Form 4, format of annual reports is given, that is to be submitted by operators of plastic waste processing or recycling facility to the local body. In Form 5 also, format of annual report is given on plastic waste management to be submitted by the local body, whereas in Form 6 also the format of annual report is given, and this format will have statewide status of implementation of plastic waste management rules 2016. Let me discuss some important conditions, those are given in the rules. Conditions regarding manufacture, storage, import, stocking, sale and use of carry bags is given in the rule 4. The important conditions which are given are that carry bags and plastic packaging to be in natural shade without any added pigment or made using only those pigments and colorants. Carry bags made of recycled plastic or products made of recycled plastic not to be used for storing, carrying, dispensing or packaging ready to eat or drink foodstuff. Thickness of plastic bags raised to 15 microns. Earlier this was 40 micron in 2011 rules. Then closure of all unregistered manufacturers of plastic bags having less than 50 micron thickness within 45 days of enactment of these rules. Then there is contravention to be penalized by closure and confiscation for those manufacturers those are not following this condition of 50 micron. Plastic sheet or cover made of plastic sheet used for packaging, wrapping the commodity shall not be less than 50 microns in thickness, except where the thickness of such plastic sheets impair the functionality of the product. The manufacturer shall not sell or provide or arrange plastic to be used as raw material to a producer not having valid registration from the concerned State Pollution Control Board or Pollution Control Committee. Prohibition on use of sachets using plastic material for storing, packaging or selling gutkha, tobacco or pan masala. Plastic material in any form including vinyl acetate, malic acid, vinyl chloride, copolymer shall not be used in any package for packaging gutkha, pan masala and tobacco in all forms. Recycling of plastic waste to conform to the Indian standards, that is Indian standard 14534 of 1998. The provision of thickness shall not be applicable to carry bags made up of compostable plastic. Means this exemption of 50 micron has been given to the compostable plastic. The manufacturers or sellers of compostable plastic carry bags to obtain a prior certificate from Central Pollution Control Board. So, these were the different conditions which were given with respect to the plastic. Now, let we come to the plastic waste management. Various conditions for plastic waste management are given in Rule 5. Management of plastic waste by urban local bodies. Recyclable plastic waste to be channelized to registered plastic waste recyclers. Every person recycling or processing plastic waste to get himself registered with State Pollution Control Board or with pollution control committees. Local bodies to increase the use of plastic waste, preferably the plastic waste which cannot be further recycled for road construction or energy recovery or waste to oil, etc. Draft guidelines for disposal of non-recyclable plastic waste have been prepared and put in public domain for objections and suggestions. Thermoset plastic waste shall be processed and disposed of as per the guidelines issued by Central Pollution Control Board. Guidelines issued by Central Pollution Control Board under this rule for disposal of thermoset plastic waste including sheet molding compounds and fiber reinforcement plastic dated 25th May 2016. Central Pollution Control Board guidelines mulled into a three-pronged strategy. First, to minimize waste and use alternatives which can be recycled. Central Pollution Control Board has preferred co-processing of thermoset polymers in cement plants. And third one is disposal in secured landfills. The inert from recycling or processing facilities of plastic waste is required to be disposed of in compliance with the Solid Waste Management Rules 2016. And these solid waste management rules you will study in another module. Unregistered persons prohibited from manufacturing carry bags or manufacturing and recycling plastic carry bags, multi-layered packaging application for registration to be filed with the State Pollution Control Board before commencement of the business. Renewal of authorization and registration, submission of action plan for setting of plastic waste management system. Action plan to be endorsed by Secretary in charge of Urban Development Department of the State government. State Pollution Control Board to ensure that they have obtained requisite sanction under Water and Air Act. No registration or renewal unless entity is registered with district, industries, center, etc. Application for registration to be decided within 90 days. Initial registration to be for a period of 1 year and renewal for a period of 3 years. State Pollution Control Board empowered to cancel, suspend or revoke the registration. Opportunity of being heard to be given. Renewal application required to be made at least 120 days in advance. Let me have a look on different rules. The rules shown here are related with the responsibilities of different bodies. Rule 6 gives the responsibilities of local bodies. In Rule 7, the responsibilities of Gram Panchayat are given. In Rule 8, responsibilities of waste generator are given. In Rule 9, responsibilities of producer, importers and brand owners are given. And in Rule 14, responsibilities of retailers and street vendors are given. In Rule 13, responsibilities of prescribed authorities are given. In Rule 16, state level monitoring committee is given. In Rule 14, annual reports. In Rule 11, marking or labeling of the plastics is given. And in Rule 15, explicit pricing of carry bags is given. Let me discuss these responsibilities and conditions in brief. Responsibilities of local bodies. To ensure segregation, collection, storage, transportation, processing and disposal of plastic waste. To ensure that no damage is caused to the environment during these processes. To ensure channelization of recyclable plastic waste fraction to recyclers. To ensure processing and disposal on non-recyclable fraction of plastic waste in accordance with the guidelines issued by the Central Pollution Control Board. And to create awareness among all stakeholders about their responsibilities, to ensure civil societies or civil groups working with waste pickers, to ensure that open burning of plastic waste doesn't take place. You know that if you do open burning, that time toxic gases are produced. To establish plastic waste management system, system to be put in place within 1 year, relevant bylaws to be amended or promulgated. Central Pollution Control Board has directed the local authorities to ensure that there is no littering of plastic waste in public, religious and historical places within 60 days of the date of notification of these rules. Municipal authorities have been directed to collect the plastic waste and dispose the same as per Plastic Waste Management Rules 2016. Let me have a look on the responsibilities of Gram Panchayats. Gram Panchayats are to set up, operationalize and coordinate for waste management in the rural areas of the country, ensure segregation, collection, storage, transportation, plastic waste and channelization of recyclable plastic waste fraction to recyclers having valid registration. Then Gram Panchayats shall be ensuring that no damage is caused to the environment during this process. Gram Panchayats shall be creating awareness among all stakeholders about their responsibilities and they will also be ensuring that plastic waste is not burnt openly. Let me come to the responsibilities of waste generators under these rules. The responsibilities of waste generators are to minimize generation of plastic waste and to segregate plastic waste. Not to litter plastic waste and ensure segregated storage of waste at source and handover segregated waste. Institutional generators of plastic waste to segregate and store the waste as per rules. The institutional waste generators to hand over segregated waste to authorized waste processing or disposal facilities or deposition centers, to pay such user fee or charge as may be specified. Event organizers, which involves service of food stuff in plastic or multi-layered packaging to ensure segregation and management of the waste generated. Now, let we come to the responsibilities of producers, importers and brand owners. Their responsibilities include to establish waste collection system as per EPR authorization. Primary responsibility of packaging waste collection is of producers, importers and brand owners who introduce the product in the market to submit a plan for collection of plastic waste. Already registered brand owners to submit such plan within 1 year. Manufacture and use of non-recyclable multi-layered plastic to be phased out in 2 years' time. The producer to apply for grant of registration within 3 months from the date of final publication of the rules in the official gazette. No unregistered producer to manufacture or use any plastic or multi-layered packaging for packing of commodities after 6 months. Every producer to maintain a record of details of the person engaged in supply of plastic used as raw material to manufacture carry bags or plastic sheets, etc. Let me come to the responsibilities of implementation and monitoring agencies. Let me come to State Pollution Control Board or Pollution Control Committees. They are the authority for enforcement of the provisions of the rules relating to registration, manufacture of plastic products and multi-layered packaging, processing and disposal of plastic waste. Then let me come to Secretary in charge of urban development of the state or a union territory. He is the authority for enforcement of the provisions of these rules relating to waste management by waste generator, use of plastic carry bags, plastic sheets or like, covers made of plastic sheets and multi-layered packaging. Let me come to the responsibility of retailers and street vendors. Retailers or street vendors know to sell or provide commodities to consumer in carry bags or plastic sheet or multi-layered packaging which are not manufactured and labeled or marked as per rules. Retailers or street vendors selling or providing commodities in plastic bags or multi-layered packaging or plastic sheet not manufactured or labeled or marked as per rules, liable to pay such fines as specified under the bylaws of the local bodies. Let me come to the responsibilities of Gram Panchayats. Gram Panchayats are the authority for enforcement of the provisions of these rules relating to waste management by the waste generator, use of plastic carry bags, plastic sheets or like covers made of plastic sheets and multi-layered packaging in the rural areas of all the states of the country or any union territory. Then responsibilities of district magistrate or deputy commissioner, DM and DC, the authority to take assistance of the district magistrate or deputy commissioner within the territorial limits of the jurisdiction of the concerned district for enforcement of the provisions of these rules. Let me come to the state level monitoring committee. The state government or the union territory shall, for the purpose of effective monitoring of implementation of these rules, constitute a state level advisory committee consisting of the following persons: Secretary, Department of Urban Development, he will be chairman of this committee; Director from State Department of Environment; then Member Secretary from State Pollution Control Board or Pollution Control Committee; then Municipality Commissioner; one expert from local body; one expert from non-governmental organization involved in waste management; then Commissioner Value Added Tax or his nominee; Member Sales Tax Commissioner or officer; representatives of Plastic Association, Drug Manufacturers Association, Chemical Manufacturer Association; one expert from the field of academic institutions; and then Director Municipal Administration. Director Municipal Administration will be convener of this committee. Annual reports. Recyclers or processors of plastic waste to prepare and submit an annual report in form 4 to the local body on or before 30th of April of every year. Every local body to prepare and submit an annual report in form 5 to the concerned State Pollution Control Board or Pollution Control Committee by 30th June every year. And each State Pollution Control Board or Pollution Control Committee to prepare and submit an annual report in form 6 to the Central Pollution Control Board regarding the implementation of the rules by 31st July every year. And Central Pollution Control Board to prepare a consolidated annual report on the use and management of plastic waste and forward it to the central government along with its recommendations before 31st August every year. So this will be the time frame and submission of annual reports. Marking or labeling. Each plastic carry bag and multi-layered packaging to have the following information printed in English: name, registration, number of the manufacturer and thickness in case of carry bags; name and registration number of the manufacturer in case of multi-layered packaging; name and certificate number in case of carry bag made from compostable plastic. Each recycled carry bag to bear a label or a mark "recycled" and to conform to the Indian standard IS 14534-1998 titled as Guidelines for Recycling of Plastics. Then explicit pricing of carry bags. Shopkeepers and street vendors willing to provide plastic carry bags for dispensing any commodity to register with a local body. The local body to make provisions for such registration after payment of a minimum fee of rupees 48,000 at the rate of rupees 4,000 per month within a period of 6 months from the date of final publication of these rules. The concerned local body may prescribe higher plastic waste management fee depending upon the sale capacity. The registered shopkeepers to display at prominent place that plastic carry bags shall be given on payment. Only the registered shopkeepers or street vendors to be considered eligible to provide plastic carry bags for dispensing the commodities. The local body to utilize the amount paid by customers for carry bags exclusively for the sustainability of waste management system within their jurisdictions. Now let me come to the judicial perspective. Plastic Waste Management Rules 2016 have planned the phase out, the manufacture and use of non-recyclable multi-layered plastics within 2 years. Let me have look on a case that is Ankur Gutka case, that is a SLP that was in the Supreme Court. In this case, Supreme Court of India expressed displeasure on the non-implementation of plastic waste management rules. Supreme Court observed that the concerned authorities failed miserably in initiating appropriate steps for disposal of plastic waste. Provisions related to constitution of state advisory bodies and submission of reports not implemented in letter and spirit, so the court directed compliance with plastic waste management rules in the Ankur Gutka case. Plastic waste management rule 2016 were challenged before the Supreme Court in various cases by Gutka, tobacco and pan masala dealers. Let me have look on one such case, and that case is R.M. Dhaliwal versus Union of India of 2016. In this case, Gutka, tobacco and pan masala dealers pleaded before the Supreme Court that 100% export units manufacturing these goods and packaging them in multi-layered plastic sachet and in other packages containing plastic be exempted from the operation of plastic waste management rules. In accordance with its earlier decisions in Baba Global Limited versus Union of India and Harsh International versus Union of India 2013, the Supreme Court exempted the units from the applicability of plastic waste management rules 2011 on the undertaking that they shall not sell the same in any part of India, means if they will be packaging, that packaging will be only for export. Another important case or judgment in this in plastic waste management rules is Karna Society for Animals and Nature versus Union of India. Petition filed before Supreme Court by Karna Society seeking prohibition on open garbage disposal system. They demanded for prohibition on the use, sale and disposal of plastic bags. In this case, Supreme Court denied of any responsibility on itself to monitor the functioning of municipal bodies and local authorities regarding their duties of collection, disposal and management of plastic waste. Although central and state governments were directed to deal with the issue with the help of committees of experts and regional benches of National Green Tribunal. So, in these judgments, we have seen that awareness in the country is increasing and people are making use of these rules to prevent the littering of plastic waste in the country, and people are using these rules so that plastic waste can be managed effectively and properly. Now, let we come to the conclusion of this module. Based upon the all discussion which we have done in this module, we can say that India has taken a step forward in reducing plastic waste to comply with its commitments towards protection of environment with sustainable development. However, the use of plastic bags is not completely banned in India. An attempt has been made to reduce and regulate the use and manufacture of recyclable plastic. The issue of littering of plastic waste on streets and roads is far too common and has created health problems as well. Plastic waste in many a times eaten by animals, leading to serious health issues. Continuous fire at landfill sites, polluting and positioning and poisoning the air has been witnessed in the past, but the local authorities have turned a blind eye to such situations. Although plastic waste management rules 2016 have provided for extended producer's responsibility, yet the modalities as to how it will work are still not clear. I hope you have enjoyed this module. Thank you.